Hello, Diamond Leaders. Today is September 28th, 2016. Welcome to our Diamond Leaders call. Do we have anybody that's new on the call? I think everybody here looks like we are all returning. Excellent. Just thought I would check. All right. So today, what I am going to talk to you about, that this is nothing here is extremely revitalizing or new to anybody. Basically, I am taking a few different personal development sources that I've had and placing them together to try and figure out a way to get out of that rut when you feel like all you're doing is chasing your tail. When you feel like you are just trying to get all of these things done, and you just can't seem to. You feel like you're not moving forward in your business, that you're struggling to try and make headway in any sort of a way, and you feel like you're always playing catch up. So that's kind of what our plan is for this morning. I'm going to go ahead and share my screen and get us started. All right, so I'm going to talk about focusing our energy on the important aspects of our business. And that word important is actually important in what we're doing. So we're going to talk about determining what's important versus what's urgent, which is actually neither. And we're going to try to launch ourselves a little bit more forward in our business. My name's Jenni Minor, and because I am blue in my color, I feel like I need to be able to have an intimate conversation with you and build a relationship. So I'm going to actually give you just a little bit of a background about myself as before we get started, because I am newer to the page. So I actually taught I still teach in the medical health and fitness fields, and had a like page before I ever even started anything with Beachbody. I had been approached several times by different people to try and become a Beachbody coach, and every single time it was always like, oh, that's not for me. No, that's not for me. No, thanks for the interest. I actually just like drinking my Shakeology. I'm just fine. And just had no desire in actually becoming a coach whatsoever. But then I met Trina, and I actually met her in April of 2015. And I decided to sign up underneath her, and the difference that really came to me when she talked was the mentoring capability. That was something that I hadn't seen that was coming into play. Before, I just thought of it as, you know, fitness coaching, and it was, and who I had been under originally, it seemed more like it was a product thing instead of a personal growth experience. And so when I ended up talking with Trina and finding out about the mentorship capabilities, and meaning that I could be able to mentor other people and get financial compensation for that, that was what sucked me in, and I said yes. So this is my first picture, my first challenge pack as we came in. Like some people, I didn't do anything in May or June or July. You'll see in just a little bit, I kind of have a busy, crazy schedule, especially in the past. And so I would say I didn't even really start doing anything at all, selling anything besides maybe a sample pack until about August 2015. So I would consider that's when I actually kind of started the business. And then I actually just reached Diamond in May of 2016. I hit it in my year when I signed up. So I was super excited. That was my goal, was to hit Diamond within a year. And I know that's a longer trail than other people, but for me, I was so incredibly happy to be able to do that because of how little time that I could really spend on it. So who am I professionally? Just to kind of give you a little background, I am an instructor. I teach at two colleges here in town. I teach at our community college, Lane Community College, and I actually am the coordinator of the exercise and movement science program. So I teach people how to become personal trainers, and we have cohorts of students who will come through. My husband runs the emergency medicine program, and I help him a lot and help coordinate all of his instructors. So although I don't work with the students as much, I actually lead all of our staff for that program. I also work with an advocate program in trying to get people to become advocates for their health in their own community called the Community Health Worker Program. I also teach at the University of Oregon, mainly anatomy and physiology, exercises, medicine type classes. And then I actually co-own a business teaching wilderness medicine in which we supervise our staff. And then my background comes from exercise medicine and blood pressure regulation and all health related as far as my graduate degree. So that's me professionally. And just because I'm blue, I'm going to share with you my other roles that I have. I am a wife. I am a mother of four wonderful kids ranging in age from 7 up through 21. I am a sister. I have 5 brothers and sisters, and we actually all got together last night, which was super fun. And my family loves to be outdoors as much as possible. We'll cycle, hiking, backpacking, rafting, kayaking, rock climbing. And I do hail from University of Oregon land in Eugene, Oregon. So that's kind of me in a nutshell. But let's talk about what we're going to do today. So what is it that we're actually doing, and where are we going with this information? So when we think about the way that we learn new information, we always try to integrate new information with what we are already knowing. So what I end up doing is when I start reading personal development, I'll read something and then, you know, you move on in another 6 months and you read a new book. And I try to integrate that with what I've already learned so it makes sense to me. And so this is kind of a compilation of 4 different personal development avenues that I've had over the last several years. And I'll kind of go through and kind of pull out where I'm getting from different things, just in case you were curious where this is all coming from. So what's our problem? So have any of you guys ever felt like you're constantly putting out fires? You're running from one thing to the next without ever really accomplishing anything. You might have big, huge dreams and big plans, and then they just never seem to fully come through to fruition. You have this great idea, and then all of a sudden you realize 6 months later you still have that great idea and you haven't done anything with it. And you feel like you're just never really able to launch your business or maybe even just your life forward like you really want to. I know that I've been in this case. So I'm going to offer you a potential solution. And what we're going to do is try to identify what's truly urgent in our life and what's truly important in our life, and realize that these are not always the same thing. A lot of times we equate them, but it's actually very different of what's urgent in your life versus what's important in your life. I'm going to encourage you guys to choose 6 projects to work on over the next 6 weeks. The number is actually kind of random, so the number doesn't matter. You could choose to do less than that if you feel like that would be a better strategy for you. And then start beginning to strategize steps toward getting you where you need to be. So I don't even know, 7 years ago, something like that, I started reading personal development books, and I was looking at the 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen Covey. And what it ended up doing was teaching a system on how to organize how important a task is by how urgent it is. So realizing that a task that you have or a project that you're working on may be important or not important, and it may be urgent or not urgent. And he ended up making a grid, and I'm kind of a sciencey person, so I thought I would share the grid with you guys. So urgency is going across the top, whether it's urgent or not urgent. And then importancy is going down on, I don't even know a word, but we're gonna go with it. It's going down the side with either important or not important. So you can have a task that's like in quadrant 1, where it's urgent and important. These are things that often happen, right? We have to get them done and they're important for us to do. However, we can also have something that is important in quadrant 2, but not urgent. These are often tasks that end up kind of going by the wayside because they don't have an urgency to them. You can also have not important tasks in your life. I'm sure you guys can all think examples of them. And some of them can be urgent, like we see in quadrant 3, or sometimes they can be not important and not urgent, like we see in quadrant 4. So we're going to work within this kind of a setup for just a little bit. I'm going to take these categories and put them at the top of the screen now. So you guys can see category 1, 2, 3, and 4 based on whether it's important or urgent. So our category 1s. We see these things as being important and urgent, and these are often things that are immediate and important deadlines, things that we need to get done. Now, I was trying to brainstorm. Now, let's put this into the realm of our business and what would be good examples of what we might see in this type of a category. And I think of things like when we're going through the Rock the Basics training as a participant, like we have to get it done. There's a deadline for us to do it, and it is important for the growth of our business to be able to go through the Rock the Basics training. Also, I would say if we are in the middle of a challenge, our challenge group posts are both immediate and important and urgent, right? So it's like you got to get a post up because otherwise you don't have one up for the group the next day. And it is important to the growth of our business. Hitting Success Club, we've got a deadline. We've got to get it by the end of the month. We're on the 28th, right? We've got a couple of days left. And if we're not there, we've got to be scrambling. It is important for us to do. Also, whenever we have any kind of like a rank qualification for events, so like trying to get the eligibility to go to Beaver Creek, right? That would be an important and urgent deadline. Sometimes I put in like the mentoring of the squeaky wheel, right? So it's like, it's important for us to mentor our coaches, and the urgency comes when it's somebody who is needing something really quickly or needing that information under a deadline. So those are important and urgent things. We also have the category two, the important and not urgent. And these are things that are like our long-term strategizing and development of our business. So thinking of examples that where I'm at in my business, inviting to coaching, right? This is not something that has a deadline on it. So it doesn't necessarily always become urgent in our minds. However, it is extremely important. Holding sneak peeks for our team to try and build up a better and bigger team. Working on your team page and developing it. These are all things that are important. Mentoring our quieter coaches. I would also, in my own personal opinion, probably put in the national wake-up call for this one. I don't listen to it on Monday morning, and so it's just, oh, sometime over the next week I should listen to that. And then all of a sudden, oh, 2 weeks has gone by and I still haven't listened to that. And so I consider that it ends up in my mind becoming something that's not urgent because there's not a deadline to it when I listen to the podcast, but it is extremely important for the growth of my business. So looking at our next category, the not important, not urgent, these are things that are more time pressures that are really more distractions than anything else. So usually it's a demand or a request from someone else. I was trying to brainstorm something that's in our business and I actually couldn't think of anything. It's actually more likely to happen when we have a boss that we need to report to, right? Something that your boss gives you as a task that you have to get done, even though you don't see it as an important thing, but they think it's really urgent. So it's often things that we're doing for other people. They're not important to us, but it's urgent for somebody else. And our last category is our not important, not urgent. These things yield very little value. They often are more of distractions. And often I think we should just cross these things off our list because our lists always become way too long. Or these are the things that we save for like a rainy day. The things that it's like, oh, I really wish I could do this, but really the importance isn't there. The example that I can give you from my personal business is that I have a quest at some point to take some of my longer Facebook posts and transfer them to my blog that I have. I should have probably written them as blog articles to begin with and then did the link, but instead I just did them on Facebook. And someday I would like to have that content under my own webpage, my own URL, and I just haven't done that. And so someday, some rainy day, I think I'll go ahead and do that. So I actually used to organize my to-do list this way. This is actually an app that I have on my iPad. This is kind of an example because I haven't done this in a while, so I tried to kind of recreate one. But I would actually list under categories of 1, 2, 3, and 4 of whether it was important or urgent and kind of go through and put my to-do list under these categories so that I could know what I was working on and make sure that I wasn't spending effort in the wrong places. I've since changed how I do my to-do lists, but you know, like doing the daily diamond or our vital behaviors that we have, I consider both urgent and important because I do need to do them every day. So I have a deadline and they are very important. Contacting coaches who are like ready to sign up and that you want to get in your group and they're, you know, you've got to hit them before the end of the month or because it's a payday. And then traveling down there, you'll notice I actually have some personal things on here too. Working on Taylor's financial management, that would be my son and trying to teach him how, because he's living out of the house and in college and like, man, that's important. I need to figure out how to teach him financial management. However, it hasn't been as urgent of a thing. Although maybe it should be. So my question for you to think about for a moment is how, in these different categories, 1 through 4, how do you think our time is spent? So I'm an interactive person, but I don't want us to necessarily open up. So just take a moment, and think to yourself, if you had to take a bet on which 1 or 2 categories we spend our most time in, which one would you say? Well, when you look at the research, it shows that we are mostly spending our time in categories 1 and 3. Now, if we look up at the top, we see that there is a commonality between those two. And it's not the important, it's actually how urgent it is. So we tend to spend our time on whatever we are seeing as the most urgent of tasks, not the most important of tasks. But how should we be spending our time? Well, Stephen Covey would argue that we're not spending near enough time in category 2. We do tend to spend time in category 1 where things are important. But category 2 are often the tasks that are needed in order to advance our lives and businesses even further, right? So sometimes we come up with these amazing ideas and it'll jump us forward, but yet we're not spending time in it. These are things that can help define our character. They help shape our future. And we actually tend to put our most important things in category 2, but yet we never seem to be able to find the time to do them. Enter my next personal development, which is Bill Hybels. Bill Hybels leads the Willow Creek Association, and he puts on the Global Leadership Summit that happens every year. It's a Christian personal development conference in which it's trying to build Christian leaders within the communities. And it's actually broadcast all over the world to like 133 different countries or something like that. And I always attend for like the last 6 years or so. And he started introducing an idea about how to want, if you're wanting to take, you have your business and your business is here and this is where it's located, but you have this vision as you reach across and you're like, that's where I want my business to be. I want to go from here to over there. And that's what you're wanting to do, is to go from here to over there. And he tries to bring ways to us that can help us make that move from going from here to over there. And one of the things he does is he talks to leaders and he tries to find out what are the struggles that we're having, what are the best techniques of trying to overcome those struggles. So he asked a bunch of leaders and said, what do you struggle with most? So take a moment and think, what do you think as leaders we struggle with the most? Well, not surprising, the answer that came back pretty uniformly was work habits. Now, what's interesting, though, of this is that we incorrectly assume that time is what's most valuable. As being a leader, the biggest thing we think we can give to people is our time. And he said, you know what? That's not actually true. What it is that it's our energy and our ability to energize our teams. So to energize people, to energize vision, or to energize an initiative that we're trying to do, that's what's actually the most valuable for us. So our most valuable player is not our time, it's actually our energy, or I guess maybe our most valuable asset that we have. And he says, this is what actually makes us unique about a leader. So other people who are working who are not leaders, time is actually one of the things that is most valuable because whatever work they're putting in. But for us, it's where our energy is and how we can energize other people. So if we are limited on time, but we have energy to be able to bring to projects, what should we be focusing on as far as trying to put our energy into it? Well, he said he came up with an idea that works for him, and I've been trying to implement it, and it's been working for me, is to identify 6 things that we could focus on over the next 6 weeks that would most move our business forward. So it's thinking of things that if I did this, my business would launch, right? It's the thing that's like, this is what's been needed. It's something that if I put my energy into this, I would be able to go further than what I am right now. These are the most unique, significant projects that we have. It's where we can make our biggest contributions, create the most impact. And so you're asking yourself, what needs my energy or what just needs to be energized? Maybe it's going to our team and to energize them to be able to complete the projects. And so he calls this the 6x6. So 6 projects in 6 weeks. So arguably, most of the items that we would be doing for the 6x6 would come from our categories 1 or 2 that we were talking about earlier, something that is, has importance behind it. And either it's urgent or maybe it's not urgent at the same time. We encourage people to actually go and write them down. The number from 1 to 6 on a card, carry it with you, and those 6x6 projects.
Yes, I don't.
Sorry, Jenni, real quick. Becky, do you mind just muting your line?
Becky? Last time I couldn't tell who it was.
I think you can mute it if she can't.
Otherwise,
let me exit out.
It's my kryptonite. I apologize. It could be fine for everyone.
And take them out. Take out the ones that I've already done.
Becky!
There we go.
There we go. Thanks.
No worries. Okay, now I got to go back and... There we go. We should be able to see me. Tell me if you can't see for some reason. Okay, so then why six? Why six? Well, his point was you can't sprint for 6 months. You can't just keep going and keep going and keep going. So he chose 6 weeks because you can sprint for 6 weeks. And then if you wanted, you could turn around and do it again. So we can do like energy bursts to move us forward. So that was why it was 6 weeks. As far as 6 projects, that was a randomly chosen number. We could choose less than that. It would be completely fine. And sometimes we have to ask ourselves, can we really do 6 projects in 6 weeks? Or are we asking too much of ourselves? And I think it depends on the project and it depends on us and how much time we have to commit towards it. So those are things for us to consider. I'm going to keep calling it the 6x6, but maybe yours is 3 projects in 8 weeks. It doesn't matter. So then I started thinking, well, that's really great because, you know, I have a lot of things that I could do to launch myself forward in my business. But my concern is if I'm spending all this time on my business, am I really doing what's important in my life, not just in my business? And so I thought, you know what? I need to integrate this with trying to build up my life as well. And then hence enters Matthew Kelly's book, Off Balance, which is trying to look at the work-life balance. And so the question started that I started to ask myself is, what are we actually moving forward? Am I trying to move my business forward? Am I trying to move my life forward? What is it? Well, Matthew Kelly says, basically, there's no such thing as a work-life balance. We try to think of these things as two separate things, where we have our work over here and we have our life over here. And the reality is they're not two separate things. There's no difference between our work and our life. Our life is our work and our work is our life in a lot of situations. And so really, it's more about trying to get our personal side of our life and our professional side of our life to become intimate with each other and to integrate them. And so people often say that they want more balance when what they really want is more satisfaction. So what I would argue is in our 6x6, we want 6 projects that can move our life satisfaction forward. So I don't think these 6 things really even have to be only focused on work. It can be focused on life things as well. So what are we not doing during this 6 weeks or not doing with these projects? Well, it should not be what we want to do or what we feel like doing. It should be things that we are actually doing to make us to move forward in what we're trying to accomplish. So sometimes we'll choose a task because, oh, that sounds fun, or, oh, this would be good. But if you really thought about it, maybe it's not really the thing that's going to launch yourself forward. And that isn't something that we should be choosing. Essentially, after we pick our 6x6 or whatever numbers you're using, we should be starting to treat everything else as secondary. It doesn't mean that we don't do those things. It just means that we're placing them as a second priority and we're focusing our energy on these 6 projects. So it's kind of like incorporating Eat That Frog, if any of you guys have read that book or listened to that book. Basically, Mark Twain had a quote that said, you should eat a live frog first thing in the morning and nothing worse will happen to you the rest of the day. So handle your biggest, ugliest topics first, the worst thing that you can think of doing first, and then fill in the rest of your day with everything else. Now, I don't think that our 6 projects are big and ugly or anything like that, but they're the things that we have a hard time implementing. So what does that look like? We would concentrate our energy on one or maybe more in a given day on our 6 projects first. before we head into our daily routine so that we don't become sidetracked by our newsfeed, our email, or these other not important and not urgent tasks that seem to like suck our time away from us. So you're probably asking me at this point, can you give me an example of what this might look like? So I'm going to show you what my 6x6 is, something that I just went through to choose in the last couple of weeks and I've started to implement. Now, these are just mine. These are not like a be all end all. This is what you guys should do. Some of you guys have already done some of these things, but it's where I'm at in my business. One of them is building up consistency. I think that that is a very important thing for me to do just because of my life and how many ways I'm spread. And so focusing on the vital behaviors, a lot of them I'm good at. Some of them I need a little bit more help with, such as like inviting to the business more consistently. I tend to do it around sneak peeks, and I need to not just do it around sneak peeks. I need to do it around other times of the month as well. So building up that consistency was one of my 6x6. And then also community building. This is a picture of my team and I with Joel Freeman, who's coming out with the Court of Force when he came to our Super Saturday. And so I wanted to build my team more. I am in a place where I really feel like community building is what I want to focus on. And having consistent team meetings, having engaging posts on my team page, doing live freedom or power hours together. I want to have an easy way for my team to be able to meet with me. Right now, it's all just through personal communication. Whenever we want to meet, and they don't have an easy way to reach out to me so that they don't, it feels like it's a struggle for them to try and, you know, book a meeting or to go out to tea with me. And so I actually want to put together the acuity scheduling as well. So those are two of my 6 projects that I'm working on, and I've actually made a lot of headway in that in the last couple of weeks. The other thing is trying to grow my team in numbers. And so one of my projects that I'm starting to implement and put together is an ongoing coaches sneak peek, a group that I can just place people into and say, hey, look at post one and go through it. And it doesn't matter what time of the month that it is. I've just got an ongoing coaches sneak peek that's happening to try and grow my team, which is Team Believe. And then team building, trying to get my current team members to build their businesses stronger and more solid. So like an Elevate to Emerald group or a Diamond Dash group, right? Something that we can do to try and build my team members to have strong businesses. I also, because I sometimes add right at the end of the month, to turn around and put somebody into Rock Solid Start is so difficult because it's like they like have barely signed up by the time we're usually starting. And so I'm wanting to kind of create a system so that they could maybe give it a week or two and then start to come in. So one thing I'm working on is I would love to put together a new Coach Basics or a new Coach University so that then I can do that over that first month. But it's not like immediately after they sign up, so that then they could enter Rock the Basics 1.0 that next month coming in. But I don't feel like I'm rushing them into something that they're not quite ready for. So that's another one of my projects. And then, as I said, I wanted to incorporate things that are not just business related. And one of the things that I'm feeling like I need to work on in my life is my relationship with my spouse. And so we're working on doing date nights or date days, and having more intimate and in-depth communication. So that's me and my husband in Hawaii. So that's something that I'm incorporating in my 6x6. So the thing we need to realize is that we can't keep the same schedule and get the same results that we have. So we can start to reframe our thinking, but if we try to do everything the same, it's just not going to work. So what I've started doing now is designing my schedule around my 6x6. So what I do is spread my tasks out over the week. I have changed my to-do list. I'm a to-do list person. I now started using Wunderlist, thanks to Trina, who showed it to me and is working so much better for me than what I was using. And I will actually schedule my tasks out over the week or as they come up. And the tasks that I work on first during the day are my tasks that are for my 6x6. So if it's on my 6x6 card, those are the things that are coming out first, right? And often these are focusing on my category two, my important but not urgent tasks that I have. Secondly, I'll work on tasks that I have assigned throughout the week. So for instance, I've got a different theme that comes through on my social media, on my like page every day. And so on Monday, I do a Monday morning challenge. And so on earlier in the week, I'll start preparing that post. And so that's usually kind of my second priority tasks, is to get those done in advance. They've got a deadline to them, so I schedule them out. And I put them in the category one, that important and urgent, because I need to get them done by a certain day. And I work on those after my 6x6. But thirdly, I'll go through and I actually do my daily tasks. This is my consistency from my 6x6, but I like to save this to the end because it seems to take the most time if I let it. And so I'm trying to focus my energy on that instead of spend all my time on it. So that's where I'm trying to put my energy bursts into it. And if I've already worked on my 6x6 and some of my important weekly tasks, now I feel like I've got to be more effective in my time when I'm doing this. And then if there's any time left over, I'll go through to my to-do list and go to other things that I have. But honestly, I really haven't been working on things that aren't on one of these three different types of categories. So I eat my frog, that's my little frog there, and doing my 6x6 first. And I take that and do that first so that my other time isn't filled up as we go along. So this is what my to-do list looks like now. This is a glimpse of what I have to do today. It puts it in its own order. I haven't been able to figure out how to order it differently, but I start with my Team Beachbody larger projects, which is part of my 6x6. So today I'm actually going to work on my acuity scheduling and trying to get my account up and get stuff on the schedule so that people can meet with me. Below it is kind of like my daily tasks that I like to do. I like to-do lists. I like to check them off and it makes me feel good. And then I have to incorporate other things that I have to do in my life that are timed. And then I start to put rankings on them of what categories they are. So for instance, for my job at the community college, we just went through an application process for our second year students. I would consider this not very important, but it is an urgent thing that I need to get done for that job. So this is, I have to report to somebody else and I have to notify these students whether they've gotten into the program. In my mind, they're already in the program. So I don't really, it's not an important task for me that I have to accomplish, but there is an urgency to it. So I gave that the category ranking of 3. So now when I go through on my list and I'm like, okay, what needs to get done? I can actually take a look at what category I'm putting it in and be able to focus my efforts on the things that are urgent and important and then work my way from there. So that's kind of what I wanted to present to you guys. I do want to be able to spend a little time just focusing and getting us and or getting you guys to think about what your projects might be. Basically, my take-home message is, though, that we weren't made to be leaders to be able to respond to things all day. It's not about response. It's about leading things. And so I needed to take more control of my day. And this is how I've been doing that in the past couple of weeks. So I'm going to open it up and take a look for questions. I'm going to stop sharing. Oh, there's lots of chat. All right, let's take a look. And if you guys have anything verbal that you want to jump on and say, please do that. Yes, go Oregon. Totally, April. I'm so glad you're on the call. Got to represent Oregon. I do have a huge family, Kim, and they're all so incredibly talkative and active. Yes, I do have a college-age son. He's 21. I know. I look so much younger than what I am, but I did have him young. Oh, thank you, Danielle. I love that. I'm going to take that link. I'm going to actually copy and paste it right now, or copy it. All right. Any questions that you guys have that weren't on the chat? It looks like everything was there. No? So here's what I'm going to encourage you guys to do for a moment. Let's just take a moment to brainstorm. Hopefully you guys all have a piece of paper out in front of you and you probably already have things in your mind, right? You've got things going on that are like, oh, what is it that I could be doing? What is that next project that I need to do? So let's take a moment to actually brainstorm a couple of projects. You don't have to come up with all 6 of them right now. I'm not going to hold you to it, but I'm going to play a little bit of music in the background and I actually want you to use it as a work section right now. If I don't do it now, I won't do things, right? So let's do it now for a moment and actually brainstorm what are some of your projects that would launch your life better.
Jenni, do you leave these projects to be like big projects? Like the first thing I'm thinking of is I was working on a website, which is obviously a big project.
Yeah. So
what about like success, like just hitting Success Club or, you know, your team meetings, which are not quite as big of a project?
I would say whatever you think you need to do in your business that will launch it forward, something that is going to take you a step further than where you're at right now. So it doesn't have to be like a huge scale project. Sometimes they can be small things, but it's something that it's like, if I did this, my business would be so, or my life would be so much further in like 6 weeks from now. And it's something that I've been putting on that back burner.
Jenni.
Yeah.
I think because your headphones are in, I don't think we can hear your music.
Hey, valid point.
And the reason only reason I know that is because I've done it several times.
I saw Teresa's note of like, you have to mute. And I'm like, I don't think that I could mute. You wouldn't hear the music.
I did it on a live feed and I was doing a Zoom. Like I was interviewing someone and I was like so excited and having her. And then she starts talking and everyone in the live feed's like, we can't hear. It's like a solid 30 seconds. I'm like,
you learn something new every day. Just like another minute or two of brainstorming, and then I'd like to share and find out what you guys came up with.
What if our baby comes in after night? What if your eyes close before? Thank you. lose yourself sometimes, then I'll be the one to find you safe in my heart. 'Cause I am giving up on making passes, and I am giving up on half-empty glasses, and I am giving up on greener grasses. I'm giving, 'cause I am giving, I am giving, I am giving, I am giving, I am giving up on green grass. I'm giving up for you. Oh, oh, I'm giving up for you. Oh, oh, I'm giving up.
All right, I'm gonna pause us and I'm gonna put in my headphones so that I can hear you guys again. So, oh, that's awesome, Teresa. All right, so what I thought we could do is if you guys are, I saw some people are already up here and putting some ideas up here. Does anybody wanna unmute and talk about like, what do you think are your top one or two projects that you think is it going to move you forward that you've been wanting to do and just haven't done yet?
I have one.
Yeah.
This is so silly, but it's like we, for some reason, my husband and I, we use like the Google Calendar and we go back and forth and we invite each other to different things. And like, sometimes it's just not working. Like we're just like, why is this not working? Or it shows up in different calendars, or we're just having tech issues with it. And we keep saying, we need to go to the Apple store. We need to just like get down, you know, we just keep saying it and then we just blow past it and we keep going, but we hit that same battle over and over again. It's kind of that, like, it's not urgent, but it is important.
Yeah.
To kind of line that up. And so that's just kind of one that popped into my head right away that, you know, it's, we use that. I use that in business too. And I use that. I mean, it works, it's functioning. But it's just like, it's not always like, you know, coming together exactly how we want it. So that was my thought.
That's awesome. Can I tell you something that I did a little bit ago that really significantly helped my family?
Yes.
I made a calendar that is a family calendar. Mm-hmm. So instead of me sharing with him and him sharing with me, we have mm-hmm. one that's for family things, which it like involves all of the kids' sports practices and games and everything like that. And we put it into that calendar. So it just automatically, and we both have that accessible on our phone. So there's less
inviting. So you subscribe to that calendar versus yes. like, oh, here's Will's football game. Here's Brady's work schedule. Da, 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 da. Yeah.
Yeah. It's just a thought.
That's a great thought. Thank
Wait,
you.
What's the calendar? I'm sorry. I think I missed something. I was looking at the chat.
No, no worries. So I made, like, you can make different Google calendars, right? So I used to have one that I organized for my work and that I make one that's just for our family. And it includes all of the family events. And in fact, my 21-year-old who doesn't live with us anymore, he also has it so that it's like my way to be able to communicate with him on like family events. So I don't like, oops, I forgot to tell you we were going over to grandma and papa's for dinner. And so I just put everything on the family calendar and then everybody knows that it's going on.
Everyone subscribes to that calendar.
Yep. And it pops up into their calendar.
Yeah. So it's like a master list of like functions.
Yeah.
Well, Jenni Minor, you're a great teacher.
Every once in a while. I am loving all these different things. Anybody else have one they want to share that isn't written already?
Well, I wrote mine down, but mine is a monthly team dinner or like a team get together, because I'm not good with that. And I put a lot of time into a lot of people, and I'm like noticing successful coaches, and I'm like, gosh, the only friends they really post are like their coaches. I'm like, maybe just need to focus on that for a little bit. So we have a very big team here in Virginia Beach now. So just trying to get everyone together and get people connected. And a big thing, I don't know if it's for you guys, but right now a lot of my coaches are asking for success buddies. And I keep encouraging to look through Rock the Basics. And I feel like they're asking and people already have one. I have four. And I keep trying to tell them, like, you don't need just one. Like, one might serve this purpose and the other one might serve a different purpose. So like, so just trying to get them together face to face and find people that they connect with or maybe live near or can work out with or, you know, interact with a little bit and be more positive and inspiring with each other. So
that's an awesome,
that's a big one.
Backing on Danielle's too, is just, we had been doing as a team getting together once a month. We were having our big diamond dinners from Shelley's team on down, Shelley Gonzalez's team, and we kind of fell out of the habit of doing that. And I was thinking about that as well, as that FaceTime for us as leaders was really powerful, but also how then we're able to use that in our social media to show our community, to show other people, like, this strong group of women that are gathering and just this camaraderie we're having in this community that's developing and growing. I feel like also communicates a lot of value beyond, like, going back to what you had said before, Jenni, about like not versus just products, but like we have this just incredible community that we're part of, and it's not always easy to convey that, communicate that to other people.
I'll tell you, April, I'm totally jealous of your diamond dinners, and I've always wanted to be like, let me come up.
Come up.
I'm only 2 hours south of you. I want to
come. Yeah, well, we'll have to do a little better planning in advance, and then we can know doing
it. The Kim, were you still asking the calendar again? It was a Gmail. Okay, you were good. Just making sure I got your question. Anybody else have one they want to share? So the idea then is that you would pick one of these projects, and then you could start coming up with ideas. Like, what is your to-do list to be able to accomplish that project? Like, what are your strategies? What are the things that you need to do? Like, part of mine was building up the community in my team. And so one of the things I'm doing today is that acuity scheduling, so that, you know, and you can start to put form to your days. And then I actually schedule them out and be like, okay, Wednesday I'm going to work on this because I know I have this chunk of time. Thursday I'm going to do this. And then it pops up on my wonder list and just tells me what I need to do on that day. And I just do those things because that's the way that I like to operate. So Melissa, you're saying one of yours is to really analyze what's been working monthly and creating a calendar to ensure they get done. Nice. Creating that consistent calendar that works. Awesome. Well, that's what I have for you guys today. I appreciate you guys all coming on and joining us. Yeah. Your cat, Kim's cat there.
His name is Dr. Dre, but his sub name is Garfield because he eats everything. Yeah. Look how cute he is.
I like how he has a sub name.
You're so cute. Thank you.
Awesome. Well, I'm going to go ahead and end the meeting. I hope you ladies all have a wonderful day, and I will see you soon.
Thank you, Jenni. Good job. You're such a good teacher.
Thank you.
Thank you.